All right, welcome back to Mike on the Mandolin. Super happy that you could join me here today. I'm going to be talking about something a little bit different today. One of the most common questions that comes up either in Mandolin Cafe or on the Mandolin Facebook group is which pick should I be using? And so today I'm going to break that down and talk about what are some various options for picks, and I'm going to show you what they sound like. Now, a little bit about the setup. I'm actually doing this in my recording room right now. And the walls are treated, so they're acoustically treated walls, and I'll show you a picture here. And I'm recording into an NT1 Rode NT1 mic, I believe, and into an Apollo interface. So from a recording perspective, this should be pretty dry. It should be pretty neutral in the sense that there isn't a lot of going to be a lot of room noise within this. And so it'll give you a sense of what the pick is doing and what the mandolin is doing with the pick. A couple of notes though. I would listen to this on your headphones. If you're listening to this on an iPhone or an iPad, you're not really going to be able to hear some of the differences between the picks. So I put on a set of headphones before you finish watching this, or before you start watching this, I guess. So there's a whole bunch of different picks that I have that I've kind of collected over the years, and I've given each one a try to see what, to see what I like about each of the different picks. And I've got everything from the thin guitar picks all the way up to like a really thick blue chip, or even kind of the smaller kind of jazz picks that are out there. So I'm going to go through each one by one. I'm going to talk about the pick a little bit and show you what it sounds like. There is no wrong or right answer here. It's very subjective. For me, I've got my own preference of what I want my mandolin playing to sound like, and you might have something that's totally different in your head. And so I think pick choice is like string choice. It's like mandolin choice. You've got something in your head that you're trying to express, and that may be different for every person that's out there. So I'm going to talk about this from my perspective. I'm going to show you the pick. I'm going to talk about it, and hopefully it'll give you a sense of what it sounds like. And then also I'm going to provide my own commentary, which may not be your own. So let's get started here. This pick right here, it's probably the most hopefully you can see that there, most ubiquitous kind of guitar store pick. It's the standard really thin, flimsy pick that you might pick up for a guitar. I just happen to have one in my case, and I'll show you what it sounds like. So I'll give you a quick scale here. Not going to really play through tunes. I'll just play the scale. I'll maybe give you a couple chords. Right, so. So what I find about this one is it sounds kind of it's got quite a bit of high frequency in it, so that it's definitely got some edge to it. I hear a lot of the pick noise. But what I'm not really hearing is the really nice sound of my mandolin and kind of the tone that I can pull out of it. So this is definitely not my favorite pick. And any of the ones that are kind of in that flimsy stage, it kind of does the same thing for me. So here's another one, very similar, maybe a little bit thicker. Again, these little flimsy picks, you might like them. I would say I'm going to show you some other picks that are definitely pull more tone out of the mandolin. So up next, I've got this wood pick that it was given to me by a friend, and I'll show you a close up there as well. So you can see this is just a wood pick, and show you what that sounds like. Right, so it's got. So to me, it feels it's nice that it's nice and thick, right? But it's got a bit of a to my ears anyway, it's got a bit of a scratchiness to it. I can hear, and I can definitely hear lots of a pick click. know, and in the context of a chop, if you're putting a rhythm track on a bluegrass song, having that might not be a bad thing. All right, so that's the wood pick. It's not one that I use on a daily basis, but it's kind of an interesting pick. So another pick that I received was this one right here. It's made out of horn. And I can't remember if it's deer or antelope, but if the same friend that gave me the wood pick provided this to me as well. So I'll show you what that sounds like. So again, this one to me, it's nice because it's nice and thick and it's easy to play with. But it's got a bit of scratchiness to it, and it kind of clings to the strings a bit. So I think it's because it's a little bit rougher. So that's the horn pick. And I mean, it's not my favorite pick to play with, but definitely, you know, lots of people might play with wood picks. So here's another pick that I received from a friend, and this one's metal. So we're going through all the different products here. We went through plastic, wood, antler, or horn. So yeah, this one's metal. So it's got, yeah, you can kind of hear it. It's got a bit of a metallic sound, metal on metal. I'd have some serious qualms about, or you know, it'd give me pause to be playing with this for a long time on a wooden instrument, because I just feel like if I, you know, was playing too hard and slipped off and hit the wood, that you'd put a pretty big gouge in your instrument, you know, and could inadvertently really mess things up a bit. So, yeah, this one, it's hard. The hardest one probably of all the picks that I have. But it sounds metallic, right? So sounds a little bit metallic to me. I've got one more wood pick here. And I think this one is also handmade. And I think it's got some kind of piece of metal in it. So I don't know whether that's a nail. It's probably a nail. Maybe it's a bullet in there. I don't know. It's a better story. There's a bullet in my pick. So you can see here, I'm going to give this a go. Same thing. Pretty much has the same qualities as the other pick, right? The other wooden one. Yeah, okay. So those are kind of ones that I've got in my box and I don't necessarily play with. I don't play with them. And they're just kind of in my pick collection. The ones that I'm going to show you next are kind of, I might play with them if I happen to have them. It'd be kind of what I'd be looking for first. One of the things I didn't talk about with regards to these picks before I move on is the size, right? So you can see these aren't that big, and I find that for playing mandolin I want a big pick, right? So not only am I worried about the material that it is and the tone that it's giving, but I also want to have a nice pick that's nice and big so that I can you know, get a good grip on it when I'm playing. And I find that it's with these little guys, it's too persnickety for my hands. So I like these bigger ones, these big triangle picks. I think they're about the right size that you want for a mandolin. When you get them in your finger and your thumb the right way, they really, you know, you've got some pick sticking out. So this next one here is just a big, thick Dunlop plastic pick, right? So it's just a big, thick plastic pick. I'll show you what it sounds like. This is the right size, though. This is where I want to be with my size. So you can hear, it's still got a bit of clickiness to it because it's that thick plastic, but it's pulling out a little bit more of the tone of the mandolin, and I'm hearing more mandolin there. It's really, really subtle, but I can hear it. I'm listening right now with headphones on while I'm recording, and I can make a big difference out of that before the other picks or above the other picks. And I like the size of it. But again, this isn't my main pick. It's not the one that I'm playing with all the time, but you can hear what it sounds like. So if I was going into the music store and I had to pick out a pick, it would definitely be one of these big triangle picks to start with. If I didn't have any choice, just the size would be enough for me. So in that kind of range, though, of triangle picks, this is a Tortex pick. So this is the, I believe, made by Dunlop as well. And it's a little bit of a softery, rubbery material. You've probably played with one of these before. This is kind of what I started out with. It was recommended to me by a friend. And it's kind of where I started, and you can hear it, you can hear the difference, right? So it's got pulls out more tone out of the mandolin. Doesn't have that harsh pick click. Allows you to give that nice rest stroke through the string. Big enough that you can control it, right? So it's got enough we've got enough size on it that you can give it that control. All right, so that's the Tortex. If I was in a pinch, I'd play with this. It'd be one that I would use. So last year, I'll move on to the next one. Last year, the year before, for my birthday, I wanted to order a blue chip pick. I'd heard about it on Mandolin Cafe and seen people play with it. Of course, Chris Thiele plays with a blue chip pick, or did. He had his own version, which is right here, the blue chip CT55. This, for a long time, was my main pick. You can hear it's got... So it pulls out a lot more out of the mandolin than the other picks. Right. What I love about this pick is its size. So it's easy to hold on to. It's got a nice bevel, so it's got the speed bevel on it already, and it's made out of this super, I forget what the plastic's called, but it's this space age material that doesn't seem to really lose that bevel, and it's self lubricating, so it really glides across the strings like really well, right? It's just always got that. Right? So it's easy to play with. I remember when I first got it and I started playing my mandolin, I was like, holy, like, I couldn't believe how easy it was to play with compared to other picks that I'd use. So honestly, if you're getting into mandolin, I'd recommend checking out some of the blue chip products. I've played a few of their other picks down at Gray Fox last summer, and they have some really nice picks, and honestly, it's worth it. If you look at $50, $60 for a pick, if you've paid, you know, multiple thousands of dollars for a mandolin and you're trying to get the best sound out of it, you know, there's worse things that I've spent money on. You could go out to a pub and buy a couple pints of beer and a plate of nachos, and you're getting close to, you know, having a really nice pick. So, you know, skip the weekend at the pub, and I'd recommend grabbing something like this. Yeah, I just think it's a I love that pick. It's one that I played with for a long time. So kind of going up in thickness is one of these jazz picks. It's very, very thick, but really, really small, right? So I feel like this pulls some tone out of my mandolin, which I like. But I have too much problems holding on to it. And I'm not sure I'd want to be chopping with this. I feel my fingers brushing against the strings because I'm not getting far enough away because the pick isn't big enough. But I could see this being a useful pick if you're doing some more jazz-oriented stuff. So one of those picks will give you another sound. And last but not least, is one of these. And I'll show you what that sounds like. So this is very comparable to the blue chip. It's really smooth. It's easy to pull it across the strings. Pulls a lot of tone out of it. I'd probably say, I guess, so the question I have is which one is your favorite? Which one do you like? I'd really love it if you'd leave a comment below. I'd love to hear what people think of the different picks that are there. Hopefully, I gave you enough time to be able to hear it. I didn't want this video to be too long. My favorite is the blue chip. I really like the blue chip for what you get. Yeah, my favorite is the blue chip. I think what you get out of it really gives you a lot of tone. It's definitely some speed. It doesn't have a really high, shrill pick click, which I think comes from some of the other thinner picks. And at the very least, I think if you're not going to get the blue chip, you should definitely think about one of these Tortex picks. I think that the size and the tone out of them is. Is pretty decent, especially since they're really, really cheap. So that's really my rundown of some of the different picks that are out there. Of course, this is really subjective. What I like may not be what you like, and what you hear may be different than what I hear from the perspective of what sounds good. And so you really have to make up your own choice on this. But if you're just getting started and you're wondering what pick to get, this should give you a bit of a rundown of how they might sound a little bit different. Of course, right hand t technique can take you a long way, right? So I see a lot of players doing, they kind of choke up with their right hand technique where they're in, right? And what I would focus on, with a good pick is nice clean rest strokes if you can, right? And that's really, really hard to do if you've got one of these flimsy picks, right? If I try to do that kind of, right, it starts to sound not nice if I really dig into my mandolin. So thanks a lot for watching. Once again, this has been Mike on the Mandolin. Love to hear your comments. Love it if you'd give this video a like. Of course, I'd love it if you'd subscribe. That really makes a big difference for me on this YouTube channel. Is the more subscribers, the better it is. So please, if you enjoyed this content and you feel I've earned it, drop a subscribe and a like. Thanks a lot. My name's Mike, and this has been Mike on the Mandolin. Until next time, keep picking.